Copy, over. Running time jump program. Opening the vortex. Start the countdown.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello everybody, my name is Blake Rizzo, and welcome to Intergalactic Forms, a Cineversity course inspired by space travel, galaxies, planets, all sorts of fun sci-fi tropes. Now, there's a lot of tools and techniques we're using here to create this scene. However, today we're going to be starting out by showing you how to reveal this hologram here using Red Giant Particular to reveal a galaxy. We're also going to show you how to create the galaxy itself. So without further ado, let's dive right in. Now, I always like to start by looking at inspiration, and this is the M83 galaxy. So one of the things I noticed is that galaxies have these big, giant, spiraling arms. They kind of spiral out from the middle, as if something is being rotated and then flying out from the center. Stars kind of collect on the arms, and then they kind of scatter outwards. There's a higher density of stars in the middle, and then the further we go out, there's a less and less density of stars. Okay, so that's a lot of good information to know. Let's go ahead and dive into After Effects. I'm gonna go ahead and create a new composition. I'm gonna call this a galaxy. I'm gonna hit okay. I'm gonna go ahead and right-click, create a new solid. This is where we're gonna add a Red Giant Particular, so we're gonna call this galaxy. I'm going to use Video Copilot's effects console to quickly go shift space, bring up a search bar, and I'll type in particular. Okay, so hitting space right off the bat, we notice that the particles emit at a point and then they kind of live and then they die. And with a galaxy, stars live for a very long time, you know, like millions and millions of years. So we need to make our particles exist from the beginning and then exist onward forever. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and click open the emitter tab, and we're gonna look for emitter behavior. So clicking this open, we get some options. Continuous explode and from emitter speed, all emit particles that live and die. Dynamic form and classic form particles live forever. They are eternal. So we're gonna wanna choose a form behavior to match our galaxy. I'm gonna choose dynamic form. For those of you that want a quick start button to get particular to match Red Giant form, there's actually a button here. It's brand new. If we click on it, it will make particular match that of the classic Red Giant form plugin. So for the rest of this, I'm actually gonna work in the designer because the designer is a great place to work. Okay, so let's see here. I'm gonna change the emitter behavior to be a dynamic form. Dynamic form works good with simulation. Classic form is good for displacements or animation over time. Classic form can also use fractals to animate position, opacity, scale. Okay, so now you'll notice only one dot is showing up. This is now where we need to think about the shape of our emitter. This is controlled by the emitter type. We have point, box, see, now it makes a box. Sphere makes a sphere, and a 3D model. We are gonna be using a 3D model in the shape of a galaxy to emit the shape of a galaxy of particles. Go ahead and click on 3D model, and then on the bottom here it says model emitter. Let's go ahead and hit choose model. And as you scroll down, you'll see there's a whole library of stuff that you could use. There is a helix if you wanted to use it, if you didn't have a model on hand. I actually made a model, so if you click this little button right here, we can load in our custom model. There it is. I called it Galaxy Base Mesh. We scroll to the bottom, it'll be right here, Galaxy Base Mesh. Apply. If you're curious how I did this, I used a curve object in Blender. I edited the curve to match the shape of the galaxy, and then I added geometry along the curve, and I simply scaled down the geometry at the tips of the curve, and then made the center a little bit bigger. Okay, back in After Effects here. I already know we need more stars, right? But, you know, as we add more stars, you see it gets a little dense. So let's go over to size and rotation, and we're gonna change the scale down to like maybe 1.5, I don't know. Maybe even less. I already know also that, you know, all these particles are like the same size. Let's turn up the size random. Nice.
Cool. Well, since we're here, I always like to turn on size over, and I change it to radial. So what that means here is basically, think about this, the further we go out, we can actually start affecting the scale of the particles the further out they go. So I imagine maybe there's like bigger stars in the center and smaller stars at the end. Kind of cool. I'm just going to kind of like use a preset here, flicker slope 1, because it would kind of like slowly get smaller, but then also have random bits of big stars. I also like playing around with the size curve offset. I'm also going to randomize the opacity, and I'm also going to make opacity over radial presets and set flicker slope 1. You can see that we kind of need some more stars in here. So let's go back to emitter type. Let's crank up the particle count. Okay, it's time to scatter these. So I'm gonna go to motion effects and we're gonna look for disperse. Disperse starts to, look at that. It starts to scatter these stars. I can even change the disperse strength over to radial. I'm then gonna use the preset flicker slope 1. However, this means it's more dispersed in the center than the outside. So I'm actually gonna flip this, flip horizontal. So it'll be more dispersed on the outside than the inside. So let's try to mess around with this a little bit. Play around with the offset till we find something we really like. Okay, so let's talk color. There's a lot of different colors of stars out there. Let's go ahead and take a look at NASA. So there's main sequence stars, there's red giants, like the company? There's all sorts of colors of stars. So we're gonna randomize the color of these stars over a gradient. So let's go ahead and go set color, random from gradient. Okay, so first things first, let's see, let's do red because it's over here. I'm gonna do it kind of a pale red. And then the middle, we're gonna put maybe some yellow, make it a pale yellow. And then we're gonna make you kind of a light blue. We're gonna kind of adjust this a little bit until it's something that kind of makes sense. Maybe even paler. Yeah, subtle, nice. Okay, I really like what we're creating here, but we need to create kind of the blue nebula-like cloud that a galaxy kind of has. It's warm in the middle, blue on the edges. So I'm gonna go like this and click on duplicate systems. Now we have two of them. We're gonna start by changing the particle type to a cloudlet, and then we're gonna change the scale to be a lot bigger. Let's see. I'm also gonna change the blend mode to add, and then up the feather count. So now it's very, very blurry. I'm also gonna try reducing the number of particles. And then I'm also going to change the opacity. We want this to be very, very, very faint. Boom, there we go. Now it starts to look like a galactic cloud. Let's up the scale a little bit. And then turn down the opacity. Very subtle. 0.5? Yeah, look at that. Okay, so we're now gonna go and change the color back to radially. And that means inside will be this color and then outside will be this handle. Okay, so I start playing around with the colors. On the inside, I do a warmer yellow and then I put an orangish red in the middle and then a blue on the outside. I play around with the positions until I get something that looks like this. And look at that, we've made a galaxy. So I'm gonna go ahead and go this little save icon right here and save it as a new preset. And we're gonna call this galaxy. And we can use this galaxy for whatever we want, but we wanna make a hologram reveal for it. So before we dive into this, I want to explain a little bit of like particle simulation theory with Particular. This is essentially a simplified version of what we're going to be doing. We're going to be using predator-prey simulation to basically get a hologram to reveal itself. So as you can see, our first system here is a predator system. It basically emits particles and they run off to these red particles. And then when they hit them, they turn into this third system here, which is green, and the green ones show up as soon as the white particles impact the red particles. So basically, what we could do here, if I turn down the opacity of our second layer here, which will be our galaxy, this acts as like a target. But then when these things kind of emit out, they reveal the actual galaxy itself. What's interesting is what we're gonna be doing here is our first system are gonna be the particles that run out to go reveal the hologram. The second one is gonna be the shape of our galaxy. And then the third one is going to be the shape of our galaxy again, except it's just gonna be revealed once the predator hits the prey, and then system three will show up. Okay, so as you can see, we're at square one here. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna label the first emitter system as predator emitter. We're then gonna bring in our hologram that we just made. I'm gonna go to custom presets, and over here we have galaxy. If I alt click, you can see that it actually brought in our preset that we made. We're then gonna make one last system, and this is gonna be the system that reveals once the predator hits the prey particles. I'm gonna start by renaming these systems. The system two, which is the star layer, is going to be target, star layer. System three is going to be the cloudlets, nebula layer. I'm actually gonna keep this one hidden for now because we're gonna have it reveal itself later. Turn the opacity down to zero. The fourth one is gonna be the star reveal layer. Okay, so you can see that the particles that are going to be revealing our galaxy are in the same exact spot as the galaxy, and I kind of want them to shoot upwards and then reveal the galaxy overhead. So we're gonna have to move the galaxy up. So let's go ahead and do that. We go to target stars, which is the galaxy. We go to mirror type. We're going to move this one up a little bit. Negative 240 seems to be a good number. Cloudlets, we're going to have to do the same thing. Negative 240, even though we can't see them, we'll see them later. And then now, look at that, gives it some room, and this will shoot up later. Okay, so let's get this going here. We are going to start and go to simulations, and we're going to go ahead and enable flocking. This will enable, like a flocking bird, these particles will now start searching for things to chase. So let's give them something to chase. Our second system, the target star layer, otherwise known as our galaxy up here, we're gonna go to simulations, enable flocking, and we're gonna set this as the prey. We gotta make sure also that if we go up here that we set our predator emitter. We have to set this to be a predator. This means it's looking for things to hunt. Immediately our galaxy starts running away, and listen, we don't want our galaxy to run away. That would be too easy. So let's go over to the predator-prey dynamics of the galaxy particle system. We're gonna turn down the evade to zero, and we're also gonna turn down the attract, the separate, and the align to zero as well. So that means it literally does nothing. Cool, so now look at this. We have these particles kind of zooming up to try to consume this galaxy. Here's what we're gonna do here. Underneath the predator emitter, underneath simulations, it says on predator prey contact. Right now it's doing nothing. We're gonna set this to kill both. What that means is that once the particle hits the other particle, it will disappear. So let's watch it. Okay, nice, looking cool. I'm going to start by turning the opacity of the galaxy to zero so we actually don't see it. That means these particles look like they're just chasing nothing. We're then gonna go down to our fourth system, which is our reveal stars. And right now it's just doing basic stuff. It's not really doing anything, but we're gonna change the emitter type to emit from parent. And this will emit from the parent, we're gonna wanna change this to the target star layer. These are the stars that are getting eaten. I'm going to set the emitter from parent behavior to at the parent end of life. That means once the particles impact each other, then this particle will show itself up, which is awesome. So I'm gonna go like this, at parent end of life, and we'll see that when they, yeah, cool, check that out. Like when it hits, they kind of explode, which is kind of cool. We're gonna then turn down the velocity to zero. So that means when they impact, dots just appear. We're also going to make sure that when they impact, that they only emit one particle. We don't want it emitting 100 particles stacked on top of each other. And since it's hard to see the stars revealing themselves, I go up to the target star layer and then increase the scale. Since the reveal stars are inheriting the scale of the galaxy, the target star layer, this will actually affect their scale. So I want the galaxy to reveal itself a little faster. So I'm gonna go over to the predator-prey simulation of the predator emitter, and I'm gonna turn up the separate and the maximum speed to see if these particles can eat their way through the galaxy a little faster. Another hack to speed things up a little bit, if you go back to the main After Effects window and go to Global Control All Systems, there's a couple values here that we can change to really impact the speed of our simulation. I'm gonna go ahead and up the simulation samples frame to maybe 4, maybe physics time factor to 3. The higher these numbers are, the faster this will go. One note, if you toss on motion blur, it can kind of look kind of cool. I kind of like the motion blur, it looks good. I also want to be able to control when the hologram reveals itself, so I'm going to add some keyframes to the particles per second. Let's go ahead and open the effects tab on the layer window, and we're going to be keyframing the particles per second, setting it to 0 to start, and then moving forward a little bit, and then setting it to like maybe like 500, and then we're going to go forward in time even more, and then we're going to set it to 500 and then 0. I'm going to adjust the timing of these keyframes here. And after playing around with the color and the speed controls, we get something that looks like this. Now we need to dial in our look to look more like a hologram. We're gonna modify the size of our particles, add some glow, add some holomatrix, and play around with the look a little bit until we get something that looks like a really cool hologram. One fun thing to use is Universe Point Zoom. This creates kind of a projection effect that can come from the source of your hologram. Okay, this is what I ended up with. I added a few rotation keyframes underneath the world transform just to slowly make it rotate. Just looks cool. If you want to add the galactic cloud, you're gonna have to actually duplicate your particular layer and put it on a separate layer and then keyframe the opacity in through the transform tab. I found that it wouldn't quite work underneath particular, so I had to just create a separate layer, but even then it's a little glowy anyways. I don't think we need it. So keep on going. I'm really happy with what we created here. It looks really, really cool. Now it's time to put it in our starship. All right, everybody, hope we had fun. Next time on Intergalactic Forms, we're gonna be giving a tour of our starship. I did some fun Red Giant Geo texturing stuff that you won't want to miss. Have a great rest of your day. My name is Blake Rizzo. I'll see you in the next one.